if you've been following this YouTube channel for a few years, you know, in my opinion, how good 30 goals is. 30 goals is kind of like a benchmark, because back when I was really getting into this sport and seeing what players would be able to produce and seeing how good these guys were, there were not too many 30 goal scorers when I really started to make this sport my home. This is because when I really started to religiously follow hockey, it was around 2014, 2015-ish, when we started to take it seriously as a fan. We started making videos about it and everything, and this season was really bad when it came to overall point production, because Jamie Benn was the guy who won the Art Ross. He had 80-something points on the year. He only had like 15 30-goal guys in the NHL, period. In fact, this is the stat line from that season. Ovechkin had 50 goals, Stamkos had 43, Rick Nash had 42, Tavares, Sagan, Tarasenko, Pavelski, Pacioretty, Ben Parise, Corey Perry, Yuri Hudler, Nick Foligno, Radim Verbata, and Sean Monahan. These were your only 30-goal seasons in 2014-15, and for a long time, this Radim Verbata season with the Canucks was the only Canucks 30-goal year that we had for years. Years and years and years. It was crazy because Verbata's 30-goal mark was never matched by any Canuck in 2016, 17, 18, 19, 20, or 21. Until last year, where the Vancouver Canucks finally broke through that 30-goal drought, and the team had three 30-goal scorers on the season. Elias Pettersson, JT Miller, and Bo Horvat all had 30 goals. Miller had 32 goals in 80 games. Petey, same thing, 32 goals, 80 games. And then you had Bo Horvat, who had 31 goals in 70 games played. In fact, if you look at the NHL from 21-22, the NHL had 51 30-goal guys, which is a crazy number when you acknowledge there were only 15 who had it in 2014-15. 7 years later, and all of a sudden there are, what is that, 35 more 30-goal scorers in the NHL? Wild stuff. We know we're in the scoring era. Everybody's getting points, and it's great. Not so great if you're a goalie, but if you're a fan of the game and you like seeing high point totals, then yeah, this is good. But when it comes to the Vancouver Canucks and their 30-goal slump, we had talked about this. Verbata was the last guy to get it until Petey, Bo, and Miller all got it last year. Well, the Vancouver Canucks had three players who have reached the mark again this season. One of them, he was traded away. Bo Horvat had 31 goals in 49 games played, which is really nuts when you think about it. Yeah, he was on a 60-goal pace right there for a good chunk of the year. It's kind of incredible just seeing how many goals that guy scored. Elias Pettersson also has 30 goals. He accomplished that in 62 games played earlier last week, so good for him to be able to get up on the score sheet. But the third Vancouver Canuck to have 30 goals on this season is none other than the newest free agent pickup the team had that has been so, so good, Andrei Kuzmenko. 63 games played, 30 goals, 27 assists, 57 total points. He's right there with JT Miller in terms of point production, and I think a lot of people could start to really bring up just the value here that Kuzmenko has. Oh, it kind of plays into the trade conversation. The Canucks should have traded him away, this, that, whatever. But like, at the same time, I wanted to go even further back and talk about Kuzmenko when he was initially signed as a Vancouver Canuck. There were some people, myself included, that made appearances on podcasts, and I said the hot take of the year was Kuzmenko would score 25 goals. And I remember being on, I think it was John Hot Take Hockey's show with them and Lucas. Yeah, it was with them, and I said that that was my hot take, and I think Clay Ema was there too, and they were like, oh wow, really? 25 goals for Kuzmenko? Okay, that's a hot take, I like to see it. Considering the fact that Kuzmenko in his prior season in the KHL had 20 goals in 45 games played and 53 total points, getting 25 goals in the NHL as a first-year player seemed like a pretty tall task. But as we've noted, over the past few months, Kuzmenko has just been so good, he's fit so well, and he is legitimately so talented in this space that 30 goals, 57 points, 63 games played, he realistically could be a consistent 70-plus point guy in the National Hockey League if everything goes right. Now, I know he's 26 years old, or 27 now, excuse me, he just turned 27 back in February, but better late than never to be making success at the NHL level, right? In fact, here's a tweet that I wanted to go over from Big Head Hockey. Players to score 30 goals within their first 63 games since the lockout. Ovechkin, Laine, Crosby, Matthews, Malkin, and Kuzmenko. And that's a pretty good list to be a part of, man. Just saying. First 63 career games in the NHL since the lockout, players to score 30 goals. Kuzmenko was a part of that with some legends of the game. Plus Patrick Laine, I guess you could say. Now, this reply from Ian kind of goes out there and rationalizes it all. I'm just going to pretend Kuzmenko isn't, like, way older than all of those guys listed in their respective first seasons, which is a fair point. Like, Kuzmenko, at 26 years old, has such a big head up on all the players who are on this list because they started their careers at 18, 19-ish years old, so it's a little different, but still, just isolating the numbers by themselves. First 60-something games played, 30 goals, very good company in and of itself, and you can't go out there and say that Kuzi doesn't deserve it. He's very good. Now, when it comes to where do we go from here, I kind of said in a prior video when the Canucks re-signed Kuzmenko that I kind of do see Kuzi as a nice bridge connecting piece for this team and its core. He probably is the most talented winger Elias Pettersson has ever played with, and if the Canucks were to trade this guy away, sure, they probably could have gotten themselves a haul, but I feel like there are other ways to free up money while also being able to keep a guy like Kuzmenko around that would make your process in shedding up the salary cap and saving money a little easier. Kuzmenko is young enough, if you wanted to say you could build your team around Petey and Hughes, to say, okay, we'll throw Kuzi in there too. He's 27 years old. Had he been drafted into the NHL, he would have been eligible for, what is that, the 2014 NHL draft, so he's in the same age range as guys like William Nylander and Jared McCann, etc. And I think if the Canucks had any of those guys, you would say, yeah, no, build around those players for the future. Kuzmenko is in that age range, so it kind of fits. If this team is so adamant on remaining competitive and building a playoff squad for next year, trading away Kuzmenko would not have been the move. Now, whether or not that's the correct philosophy to go about it, that's up in the air. That's a different conversation. We've had that conversation many times before. We're not having it here in this video. But for the Vancouver Canucks and their 30-goal slump, from Radim Verbata to Petey, Bo, and Miller, all the way here to Petey, Bo, and Andrei Kuzmenko, the Vancouver Canucks are looking pretty good in that department. Now, JT Miller is at 23 goals right now. He's got a pretty good chance to get there, too, if he's able to get 7 more goals in the remaining, 19 games. Games on the season. It's not impossible, especially with the way JT has been playing as of late, but it's interesting because this still has been seen by a lot of people as a down year for Miller, especially considering the start that he had. So 30 goal seasons come and go. Andrei Kuzmenko is the latest one to establish that, and he is putting himself in a territory that we haven't really seen too much out of when it comes to players making their debut in the National Hockey League. Matthews, Ovechkin, Crosby, Laine, these guys are right here, and these guys are all in that Andrei Kuzmenko 30 goals in their first 63 games territory. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, what you think about Kuzmenko and the season he's been having. What are your thoughts on the stat that we had brought up here? I hope you enjoyed this. And bye.